This is why carbs can boost your serotonin and your stress resistance. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about how carbs can boost serotonin and stress resistance. Now, in the last episode, I talked about whether collagen would bonk your serotonin. And the general conclusion was, as long as you're not using collagen supplements in a way that decreases your protein, and you are, or decreases your non-collagen protein, you are getting enough non-collagen protein, that's not an issue. But what could bonk your serotonin is not eating any carbs or not eating enough carbs. Being on a low-carb diet too low too often. And the reason is as follows. In order to make serotonin inside your brain, which protects you from stress, you don't want too much serotonin, but you want enough to allow you to cope with stress and prevent you from being overwhelmed. In order to make that in your brain, you need to get tryptophan into your brain. Where does tryptophan come from? It comes from the protein that you eat. It's an amino acid. You digest that protein, you get tryptophan and many other amino acids. The thing is, there are many of those other amino acids will compete for entry across the blood-brain barrier with tryptophan. And so if those other amino acids are high in your blood, the tryptophan has a harder time getting into your brain. How do you get those other amino acids out of your blood to allow tryptophan to cross the blood-brain barrier and get into your brain where it can make serotonin? Insulin brings those competing amino acids into your muscle cells. And where do you get insulin? You get insulin mainly from eating carbs. Now, generally, it's the high-glycemic carbs, which are often demonized because they raise your blood sugar. It's those high-glycemic carbs that are the best at getting tryptophan into the brain. For example, white rice has a very high glycemic index, meaning it breaks down into sugar and raises your blood sugar rapidly. And that creates a bigger insulin spike that gets more tryptophan into the brain. If you look up on Google glycemic index of foods, you'll be able to find a list of high glycemic and low glycemic foods. So those high glycemic carbs are the ones that are most effective. Now, you don't need to eat them all the time. And in fact, there's research suggesting that even at breakfast, if you have high glycemic carbs, you'll get enough tryptophan into your brain that you have it there at nighttime when you make not just serotonin, but melatonin to help you sleep. So if you can get the carbs in the morning to help you sleep at night, then it's probably just the case that you want some high-carb meal somewhere in the day if you feel that your stress resistance is low. So I'm not saying that no one will ever make enough serotonin without eating one high-carb meal a day. I'm just saying that if you feel like you get overwhelmed easily and that your serotonin could be low, it's worth testing whether having at least one higher carb or high glycemic index meal per day will help make you feel better and more stress resistant. And if it does, then that's something you can incorporate into your toolkit to feel better more of the time. Now, if you search for a list of high glycemic foods, you're going to find sugary junk food. I'm not recommending including a lot of sugary junk food in your diet. And so I would, although I'm not an absolutist saying you can never have any junk food, I wouldn't use junk food for this purpose. When you're thinking of trying to boost your mood with a daily meal that has some high glycemic carbs, I would use natural whole foods. Some examples of fairly high glycemic carbs are rice, potatoes, sweet potatoes, pumpkin, watermelon, if you eat enough of it, although watermelon is fairly low in calories, so you have to eat quite a bit to get that carb boost. So incorporate some of these foods to see the effect on your mood. I would say potatoes and sweet potatoes are the most nutrient-dense options out of the ones that I just listed. So what if you're on a low-carb diet for other reasons and you don't want to give up those reasons? Well, if you want to try an alternative to the carb approach, I would suggest trying a tryptophan supplement on an empty stomach. Ordinarily, when you get tryptophan from the protein in your food, you get that flood of amino acids in that compete with it for entry into the brain. But if you take tryptophan supplement while you are fasting, and you wait a half an hour or an hour before you eat a protein-inclusive meal, that might give the tryptophan a better chance of getting into the brain.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.